sorry about that, folks. Just need to restart the program really fast so that the sound came through properly. And let's see here. Is it working? Okay, it's working. Hooray!
Yay!
Still no audience, but that's fine. Let's see here. Well, it's November. Next month will be Grand Blue Fantasy Fest online again because of COVID. They want to be safe, keep their staff safe, keep their players safe, and as a player, I can appreciate that. More than likely, I will be working with my friend Dom to do live stream interpreting for the. Yes. If people watch this, the playback later, Chris, they can see. Okay. You're supposed to play. You're alone. You're not a little kid anymore, okay? excuse me. Don't, no. Not on stream, please. Alright? If you need to do that, please hang on for a while. Chris? Seriously, don't. It's not a good habit. in any case, as I was saying, I will probably be live streaming with my friend Dom, Vibrating Sheep, as his co-host. Once we figure out when that is going to be, it'll probably be the second or third weekend of December, but they have not announced that yet. So we'll see. What else is going on? Robot Wars 30 is out. Super Wars 30 is out. If people are curious about the series, I might take one episode in the near future and explain the series of the history of the series. I see. Christopher, thank you, but that's. Maybe we'll hear more of that song if I decide to talk about that. If people. Oh!
Still opening up cakes.
I see. If people want to hear about Super Robot Wars in more detail, I'll go into that. Otherwise, we'll just go ahead. Nothing else is really going on right now. Christopher, please don't actually choke me. That hurts. Chris, what you're doing right now is called a chokehold. Please do not choke me.
No.
And don't play with my neck folds either.
Mommy!
Alright, let's go ahead
and
get back to the hunt for all the various items to get 100%. Also, we may need to ask folks, but I guess I'll wait till actually know I have audience first. About camera questions. Alright, now we are hunting for items. So, we're here at Darien. Dairon, sorry. Got that. Trying to figure out what is missing. Rather, what I am missing, I should say. There's one easy one over here, but before we try to be a little efficient if I can. Got that. Access closed, so I can't go that way yet. Alright. Go ahead and I guess walk over. Okay.
Can I have some flacos?
Yes, Chris. Alright, so let's go straight to the left for now.
Yeah,
ありがとう。That one already. Power bomb take. Okay, got that one. Let's go get this missile tank.
Christopher, come here!
So each item is 5%, so there's 8 items left here? Good grief. There's 2 here. Oh, that was one of the parts. And there's this puzzle thing. Yeah, alright. Well, let's go ahead and bang our heads against these puzzles. I'm going the wrong way.
Excuse me.
Hey, Crescent. You know, I understand your frustration with it. It's easier for me than it has been on the Nintendo for some reason, and I don't know why. But I can't say I blame you for... your frustrations too, based on what I've seen. Yeah, it'll save while we're here too. I wish we could fast forward past this. There's that. Let's not do that yet. rot blocks. Those are. Oh, is this the? Oh, this is the. Spark from here, but Chris, calm down. You're not the one playing this. No.
Speed, but
speed,
A, E.
Oh my god, I did. Thank you, Josh, Preston, for the suggestion of the outside view there, because I would never would have. Even though I tried it that one time, I don't know if I would have kept trying it. Alright. That's 75. What else am I missing? Oh, I see. Speaking of bouncing from wall to wall, there's that money to get. We can go ahead and there next.
Where
the heck are all the items? To the third platform, good grief, okay. One of those kinds, I see. That's mildly annoying. There's not a new alien there, Chris. There was, they would show it. Maybe even another thing or something like that, but right now there's no alien. It would help if I actually hit down to, you know, start to spark. Richard, press the right button for help. Thank you. Alright, so there's a power bomb tank. Still need to figure out how to do this. Yes, she said that, Chris. Leave it alone. Mom said live boiling, Christopher. Shine spark, the normal shine spark here should probably, you know, actually activate the shine spark, huh? Alright, now we're gonna go. Yes, okay, so think there was one.
Okay.
Hidden in plain sight.
I just like those close talking.
Number 100% from Dairon, then. Viridia, 94%. Gavron, Lun, Viridia, Cataris. This goes to Arteria.
No.
Well, since we're here, may as well, then. Alright, let's do it.
Only 79%.
Yep.
Says Iron.
So we still have a bunch of areas. We're gonna hit Arteria, and then we're gonna go probably to. Carteris. Speaking of sequence breaking, actually, I'm thinking in the near future of maybe trying to do, during a 4-hour session, try to actually, like, do, I can think, really. I'm full of vocabulary. A sub-4 hour run for all of this stuff. Now that I've got practice with the game and stuff. Like, I'll look up strats and stuff like that, and oh, okay, like, this giant room of stuff. One session, just going non-stop. Let me know. So I'll have to do a speedrunning shuffle. Also, he has no shuffle. The combat is the one thing I'm actually kind of. Whoa, what the hell? slide down and go to the right. Powerbomb tank. Last one then, buddy.
I think that's the last 7%.
I think the last 7% one. Hopefully.
Last
7%. Hopefully. We'll find out.
Wee.
That's
fun.
Everyone's like slides.
Yeah.
Nope, 96%. There's still one thing I'm missing, but where? What am I missing? Got this. Not bad. Mr. Map, you're supposed to help. Please help. Does anyone know what I'm missing? Because I sure as heck can't tell. I don't see any glowing rooms.
Lava! Listen to me! Let's stand there!
I really don't know where I'm supposed to get the last whatever it is I'm missing. This is very frustrating. Seriously, what the heck? If someone can find me a map of of Artaria and maybe see what I'm missing, because I really seriously have no freaking clue where that's supposed to go at this point for that last item. calling you. Lava, but fire still hurts. Kidding. Zip across and up. Is that all? Alright.
You got this.
Thank you. probably just as soon as I get through diagonal Chinese Park instead of trying to spin. For a full energy tank, that's definitely worth the effort. Alright. That's 100%. Alright, yay. Now, red teleport takes me where? Takes me to Cataris. Where there are a bunch of things that I'm missing, so there were some. Alright. Bro, hope your charity scheme has been going well for extra life. I'll let you check the damage once I have my schedule figured out a little better. But for now, once a week for a few hours is all I can really manage. Hope the family's doing well too. Yeah, that's what I thought. But I think I was still here. I was here. It was before Kid Chris moved here.
When you were back briefly for your father's funeral.
That works.
And I believe they met once when Chris was too young to remember anything.
Well, yeah. That makes sense. Grapple me. Let's go do that
one. Okay. Please be careful, there is stock for temperature.
Refrigerator temperature.
There. guess we're asking. Good luck tomorrow. Barrel forever, man. Old death. Oh, are you kidding me? Seriously? That's kind of efficient. Okay, well there's that. Yeah, oops, all speed booster, good green. At least I got it. That's better than on the first try. Even I'm a little surprised by myself.
Bark?
Thank you, Doc. That helped a lot. Alright, 61%. There's one over here. Sponsored by no one. A fuel by Dr. Pepper. Chris. that. There's a tech here we have to get, so there's an area down here we haven't explored yet. So I think we just hooked all the way here. Yes, Mr. Fruit. First game, he's Samus-sized. In Super Metroid, he's bigger, but he's still not, like, multiple screens big. And in this one, he's, you know, ginormous, so...
A couple screens big?
100%. Alright, counter is done. I have 1,399 health. That's nice to know. So the rest is all going to be mistletoe and stuff like that. I'm assuming that's supposed to be lava and not like just really hot water. I've always wondered that, like a game where you have lava and then you have the ability to survive the lava, how do you see through it? Like radar? Sonar? That kind of thing? Gyron up to this C, we should actually give these places names and then just call them Area A, Area B, Area C. Samus elevator thoughts. Oh god, I'm sick and tired of this crap. I need a bath. Please calm down. Alright, so we're gonna head over to... Yep, A, B, C. Where's the light cyan? There it is. So let's go... Alright, So what should I play after this, folks? What should I try for that, do the under 4 next week? While the game's still fresh in my brain. There's Axiom Verge 2, which I've been wanting to play. There's a bunch of games I'll play. Alright, so where are you last night? It doesn't have to be on Terrania, it can be any other kind of game really. It can be Robot Wars if people really want to watch. Although again, I don't know why people would watch Robot Wars as much. Okay, down here. Yeah, alright. Where am I? I'm up there. Way up there. If that was how it worked, but unfortunately that's not, it is not how it works. Alright, so green teleportal up to there, so let's do that. Thank you. getting a few more ideas for my next video. Okay, off to Gavaron. Two locations left, Gavaron and Alun. With getting objects again. Like the boss. Hopefully having every weapon, every missile and energy tank will make it easier. Alright, let's see. Thank you. guess I didn't have more folder or something. 100%. Alright, that means 2, 3. All that's left is just one item in the wood. Which is just one single missile tank. That's funny. Alright, so thankfully I'm actually close to, not too far from where I want to be, or going that way, but so
Cover on, up.
Trick, what's up? Thank you for joining today. And yes, now it's time to go find out if I'm fighting Raven Beak or whoever. I'm assuming Raven Beak because they keep making him out to be the big bad, so. We need to, like, dub over seven of, like, Terminator 2 lines. I need a vacation, so I gotta draw this. Alright, so just. Can't go that way, so we have to go. Actually, we, yeah, we can go. We can't go this way, so I just need to go. What? So apparently, if you use the Omnibus to give you an energy tank and a missile tank, those are extra on top of what the game gives you, so they don't count towards the 110 kills. So, I guess, normally, 1299 is the max. Alright, so now we go here.
Thank you.
It would help if I didn't, like, flash shift into him. if the planet doesn't explode, we're breaking away from Metroid tradition, so I don't think it's any close. I'm gonna have to run for my life. See a crossover with Samus and Dirty
has caused
well.
You to become a Metroid. Ordinarily, this would have happened
okay,
immediately
Samus
after
is
the
now
DNA
Metroid.
Transplant.
Well, there we go. We keep using the Metroid name. Because Samus is now a Metroid, sure. I mean, she's been absorbing powers and stuff, so why not?
Your Pokakins must have slowed down the process. They were the only tribe capable of controlling the Metroids. Though you possess their DNA, you are not a Pokémon. Your physical prowess suggests that you must also possess Machin DNA.
Oh, because Toha apparently would never physically fit, I guess.
Metroids are programmed to identify Machin as enemies. This suggests one thing to me.
Okay.
It is very probable that your metamorphosis occurred as a result of Raven Beak's attack. His presence awakened the Metroid's killer instinct.
Metroid's killer instinct. Killer Instinct, no longer owned by Nintendo.
Since then, your metamorphosis has accelerated. It can no longer be controlled. You are now a Metroid, Samus Aran. Your very existence poses
your
a grave
threat
to the galaxy. However,
so
there is
she
no need
the next
fear.
Boss in the next game.
You can still contribute to galactic peace. You need only use your new powers.
You completed your transformation from protagonist to antagonist.
You live long enough, you stop being the hero, you turn into the villain.
I guess so. You know what they say, you shouldn't trust anyone over 30.
You have followed my instructions faithfully so far. Continue to do so. It's that simple. I consider your performance here on ZDR highly satisfactory. As I hope,
Adam's being a
it
jerk.
Has even awakened your Metroid powers. I was right to let you live during our first encounter.
Wait,
that
during our first encounter,
you told me everything.
You're not Adam.
And offer up your power. My plan is
my plan
to
only
bring order to the galaxy.
This is not Adam.
Full
you are lying liar, whoever
Samus.
You are.
This is an order. Disobedience will not be tolerated.
Adam may have been a commanding officer, but he never treated her like a servant. First encounter being in
the
daughter. You are the worst dad ever. No Father's Day card for you. Walk
god. What am I going to do now? Should I freaking...
Looks like a big ass thing I want to blow up, but. Dad's a jerk.
Eh?
Raven Beak. Dad is a jerk. Well, I guess I'll be spending the next hour trying to figure this right out. I think.
Uploading data.
Ow!
I'm going.
appreciate your support.
Gotta get better at dodging all this stuff in the second phase so I can have more energy for the third. Ah, man, my hand is starting to hurt, jeez. Do people care if I skip the phase animations?
Thank you.
quiet room. Just trying to go to the when I played this last, it was like 3 in the morning, and I don't actually remember what happened. I'm not even sure. Oh, hey, what the hell? That, that'll be painful. One more fight, I guess. Let's get ready for it. She's a green crab now. green crab Samus. Green out of the way, Chris, it's okay.
Oh. Don't. Of its energy.
Oh, hello, actual Adam. Dad, aren't you dead? Samus again. I don't want to get us the hell out of here. Executing, getting us the hell out of here, sir. Well, there we go. Metroid Dread. Woo! That last fight was, not even in my hands. I'm sure there's a faster way to beat the guy. I'm sure I'll miss the triggers or something, or openings. But, that was a lot of fun. So, for next week, I'm thinking either attempt to under 4 hour the game to get all the pictures, or at least all the pictures put on that, so I'm not going to require too bad. Or Axiom Verge 2. That game's not out yet. And that requires donations. I'm sorry, but that requires donations. Not because I have problems with the content. I don't care about, getting the Fulu girls. Sure, I'll do that. It's the pseudo-Japanese stuff that kind of bothers me. Sanity, I'm worried about not being pissed off about unintentional racism that I'm worried about, honestly. But that was a lot of fun. I'm gonna put this at number 2 on my Metroid list. My fingers are actually okay. They're just a little sore from the original. What was I about to say? My favorite is still probably Zero Mission, because it's the one that got me back into the series, specifically. Nick Maragos! Yay! Nick Maragos! Woo! Nick is an old co-worker and friend from my Atlas days. I'm always proud of the work that Nick does. So. That's cool that Nick worked on this. You should get him to sign a copy. So I think this is number 2. For game playability, this is number 1. This is the easiest to have. I have not 100% in any other games nearly this easily as I have this one. I'm not sure how long it'll take me 100% this. Not that I have my eyes, because just so much. Like, I'm hearing it's under 2 hour 100% runs. I'm like, and the answer really is just practice. Like, if I play this game a lot more, I'm trying to get the timing down and everything, not miss things, not miss jumps and stuff, but I have other games I want to play too, so that's why I'm thinking of doing like the 4 hour thing next month, just to kind of get that. Oh yeah, definitely. This is totally okay. So for me, it's Zero Mission, then this, then Super Metroid. With the caveat that Super Metroid is just barely under this, and only because I have an easier time playing this than Super Metroid. Which I know a lot of my friends, like Crescent, are actually the other way. They've got an easier time playing Super Metroid than I do playing this. Which I get. It's just the way things are sometimes. We'll be right back. Also, I gotta say, I really dig the red, blue, and white the outfit on her. It's a really nice color scheme, I feel like. I never liked the purple. Like, whenever she gets the cape, it's not... Yeah, okay.
Metroid Zero Mission! Speaking of which...
Yeah, this was the one I played before, but I was playing usually like really late at night, and I would never remember what I did the day before. I'm surprised I actually beat the game that way. So let's continue with the experience. Gallery. Oh, I think they're actually unlocking it in the order I unlock the, Oh, that's really cool. That's a beautiful picture. There's Adam in the corner there. Very nice. So, yeah, I'm told normal mode and hard mode. Maybe I'll play hard mode someday, I don't know. But, I also wish that there was a way to look at the eShop without having to lock my block or something, because I don't want to do that and possibly just my password on each player. So good. So very good. Super Metroid, of course, just, you know, really just cemented the game as what it could be. And Zero Mission is pretty much original Metroid with the Super Metroid stuff plastered back in. Plus a few extra nice things like the cliffhang and stuff like that. Or I think, what's that? Super Metroid? I don't remember. But... I don't know. So I will probably put out a quick poll later on saying 4-hour speed run or 4-hour under sub 4-hour run or Axiom Verge, start Axiom Verge up, or Super Robot Wars, not tutorial but like I guess history, and then a fourth option of like something else if you want to vote for something else. I'll put that up this probably tomorrow. Well, now that I have this, I'm going to take this, copy the slot 3, yes. While we're talking, I'm going to start this. Slot so that I can just start from the beginning of the game without going through all of this right here. I'm not gonna lie, I would love to see Metroid Zero Mission on Switch in the original form, like not remade, just something played. I think I'm going to have a time where with this controller than I would with an actual GBA. Because as I think about now, I actually have a GBA, I was like playing, I'm like, I cannot see shit. So. But Metroid Zero Mission and Metroid Fusion on the Switch would be just joyful. I would super be happy about that. Excuse me. Oh, the SAX, that... She was scary. So yeah, Metroid Dread... At this point, the enemies no longer scare me. Like, they always scared me for the first half of the game. And I was just like, not being slowed down. Well, I guess that's that, kind of the way how anything scares you can become if you really, you know, get used to it. for a long time I was scared of dogs because of an incident in my childhood. And then after a while, my friend's dog helped me get used to dogs again, and I loved that dog. The other dogs I was just annoyed by. So...
but yeah, I've been watching the numbers on the speedrun, and like, seeing bits and pieces here and there, I'm just like, seeing insane stuff, like, just crazy, crazy stuff. Like, just people doing all sorts of, like, sequence breaking that I just can't even figure out. I don't know. So who knows, maybe I'll start practicing. Because for some 4 hours, it sounds like I'm going to have to do some sequence breaking. Because, like, if an 8-hour run... Well, getting an 8-hour run, that was 100%ing it. So I'm not going to 100% it, but just go as fast as I can. What if I can probably do a sub 4... just by doing a normal run as fast as I can. Yeah, you can skip that. Alright. That apparently is how you make a save slot, so... There, now I've got my original run, a start run, and I can do that now. Cool. So it looks like, let me calendar really fast here. Next week on the 14th, we'll be broadcasting. 21st, we'll be broadcasting. 28th, we might not, because it's Thanksgiving weekend, and maybe going to a friend's place for Thanksgiving. For American Thanksgiving in Japan. If that is the case, I'll let folks know. Let's see. Again, Grand Blue Fest next month. I'll be broadcasting that with Dom, probably. You can talk to him about that. If you've got access to the Japanese Switch shop or the Japanese PS4 shop, the Super Robot Wars demo is available, and it is in English if your settings are set to English. And if you've never played one before and you like turn-based strategy that is as easy or as hard as you want it to be, Super Robot Wars is a really... Steam is available on Steam as well. Oh, that's right. The demo should be on Steam now, too, as I think about it. It is super fun. Like, as... Oh, no demo? Oh, that's unfortunate then. Boo. But as a strategy game goes, it is not the most complicated thing in the world. There's no height to worry about. You know, the three main systems in it are pretty standard, honestly. And but if you like any of the robots in the show, in the game, you know, the game serves everyone reasonably equally for like their plots and stuff like that. But as a 30th anniversary game, they just throw all sort of fun little extras and such. And while there are units that are just like, this is just way too damn strong, I have not gotten Ernie yet because I've been playing it slow because I've been working a lot on the, in the evenings for my my day gig. I'm about to get him, I think. Because I've also been doing a lot of the relic missions and the side missions just to kind of get them out the way and earn extra money and stuff like that. But really the rule of Super Robot Wars is, pick your favorite robot, make them the destroyer of the universe, and just go. Like,
one of my friends back in the day, in the older Robot Wars, would take Boss Borat, the goofy robot from Majinger Z. He'd max level to 99 in the first couple stages, and despite as long as he could get them within range, he would destroy everything with Boss Borat. It was the funniest thing in the universe to watch. You know, and he comes running around and just, yeah, God Borat, it's hilarious. You know, 99, level 99, pilots maxed out, armor and everything else, best parts, and they would just destroy everything. So you've got a flying Boss Borat, punching things to death. The relic missions, if you look around, there's 3 versions of them. 15, 25, and 40. The 15 ones shouldn't be super hard for you if you've got at least a few units in the 16, 17 range. But some of them are trickier than others, like the one where it's like take out X many enemies within one turn and stuff like that. So thankfully those are all optional, so you can always come back to those later. But I guess I'm doing the Super Robot Wars kind of history right now. If you look at the picture here, it's a little hard to see with the icon, but you got Majinger in the middle bottom, Getter Robo to the left, and then the new Gundam to the right. That's actually an homage. Yeah, the relic missions have become the SR points, really, because they wanted this to be... I feel like they wanted this to be kind of an entry point for new players, partially. Alright, thanks, Doc, for joining us. Have a good night, man. I wonder if people are... I need to check my settings, but in any case. But also, something that a lot of people pointed out is that when you've got the SR points, a lot of stages, there's really only one way to do the stage then, and that's not as much fun as like figuring out how you want to do it. Like, but making them more open SR points for Super Robot points, the SR point system made it so that the game would get harder the more of them you had, and certain endings required a certain level, a certain number of SR points based on the game. And so they said that they got rid of the system because it was forcing people to play a specific way, and they did not want to do that. They wanted the game to be open. That's the whole point of Super Robot Wars, is play however you want. You know, you shouldn't have to level a certain robot because it has the best weapon or whatever. You can say, screw that, I'm going to kill everything with Boss Borat. You know, for a while for me, in Super Wars MX, I decided I was going to put all my points into, I can't remember her name right now, Ninja Mom, from Dendo. And I powered up her motorcycle, and she was just destroying everything. Yeah, it's like there's certain, you know, like they've toned back a lot of things. Like very few people have acceleration now, you know. You know, they've done a good thing tuning the game, I feel now. So, but in any case, as I was saying, the picture with Majinger, Getter Robo, and the new Gundam is an homage to the original picture for the Game Boy game, the very first one, where it's actually the Gundam, the Getter Robo, and Majinger Z in that pose, pretty much. If I can find a picture of it, I put it up. But I don't feel like messing around with the web right now.
Have you finished the stream?
Nope, not yet. I'm just talking to folks right now, Chris. Just kind of chatting. Are you hungry? You want to watch TV, though?
I want to keep watching on my account.
Aha, uh-huh, I see. Yes, Chris, I know. Hmm. We will talk about that in a little bit, okay? Any case, so again, if people are interested in seeing more about it, like seeing how the game plays and such. You know, I wish I had, like, some of the older titles available to show folks, too, because, like, just to show how things have changed and such. My first game was the fourth one, and fourth entry in the series, sort of. Super Robot Wars 4S. As for Scramble, it was the PlayStation remake of 4 from the Super Famicom. And because it was on PlayStation, they put voices in for some of the characters because they could. But they either didn't have the rights or just couldn't get everyone available or whatever. So it was kind of fun. Just like some of the characters would be, you know, yelling their attack power names and stuff, and that it was just such a thrill. It was also the first game that had original characters that you could make your own new world. Instead of just playing and just controlling an army of characters, you could make your own character and be part of the team. And that really changed a lot of the dynamic of the game, because now it's like, I'm fighting alongside Koji and Amuro and Shoma and all the others. And I feel like that really helped make the game series much more popular. The first game, in 4S, you could choose your gender, choose your portrait, choose your personality, and choose your robot type. You can be a super robot, like Mazinger and Getter Robot, or you can be a real robot, like Gundam. And that would affect how you play the game and everything else. It also affected your character's subpilot slash love interest, because mecha shows oftentimes have love interests. And I remember playing Alpha, the game that came after 4S, and choosing a certain personality for my character, and then the personality for the subpilot was so obnoxious and annoying that I started the game over again. Just not because it was like, whatever personality you choose, the subpilot would get the opposite personality, and I chose like kind of the cold, nihilistic, cool under fire character, and so the subpilot romantic interest turned out to be the super bubbly, happy, and I was like, oh, I can't take this right now, so I started all over again. Thankfully, it was only 12 missions in when that happened, so it's like, wasn't too bad. But in any case, I don't know if people are even paying attention anymore than they're not, but so that'll be an option for next week. So yeah, Robot Wars. More talking about Robot Wars. Probably not though. 4-hour Metroid Dread, or Axiom Verge. Here on news. Animal Crossing. Danganronpa apparently is on going on right now. Mario Party. Okay, that's cute. The pumpkin, the jack-o'-lantern Metroid, or Samus. Kind of cute there. Fatal Frame. Sky Kid. Why am I getting Chinese? Okay. Grand Theft Auto? Huh. Okay, sure. Yeah, Super Robot Wars and Lost Ruins. Is that a PC or a Switch game? I'll try to check it out later, but if it is, what was I gonna say? To really kind of bring out energy here now. and then the game is done. But in any case, I'm going to just quit, cut it here for now then, and I'll try looking at that Lost Ruins that Dark Star just mentioned. So we'll see you all next week, same time, 10 a.m. And thank you for joining me today when I beat Metroid Dread. Appreciate it. Take care, folks, and we'll see you next week. Bye-bye. Thank you for watching. Doo, 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 doo.